If Evermore doesn't fucking go if to Evermore number one, what's the point fucking point of this whole thing?
I fool myself, sure.
If it's not that song, it can't be number one.
Long nights begin.
Forevermore.
Oh, hey. Oh, hey, guys. Didn't see you there.
Did you hear the news?
Oh, yeah. Did you hear the news?
Taylor is releasing another album in about
like 8 minutes. Who would have thought?
Not me. Can we just say that we manifested this? I don't know if you guys have ever seen the live action Beauty and the Beast, but there's a song called Evermore, and that we've been listening to that all freaking week before we knew. Yeah. I came out of my room screaming it the other day, and now it's been in all of our heads. So I think if you guys want to leave a thank you in the comments, that would be really appreciated because we did that.
We manifested this shit.
Yeah, so you're welcome. So basically, we're going to watch the music video, do a little cheeky reaction, crack open some wine.
Have some cheeky wine.
Have some cheeky wine. I got some pink Moscato.
Got some regular Moscato.
And we're going to listen and see what happens and hopefully not get copyrighted. So thanks, Taylor. Thank you for changing 2020. Also, I should say that we have a list of all the tracks. I put the bonus the bonus songs in the bottom, but I don't think we get them tonight, do we?
No, I don't think so.
Yeah, so they're there.
But they're there.
The last one's called It's Time to Go, and that makes me think of my mom telling me to leave somewhere.
It's time to go.
It's time to go. I think we should do a full ranking. And then in a month, after like winter break and the holidays and all that stuff, when we have time to listen to it,
we'll change.
We'll see where we're at after like a month of knowing the music.
Oh, 10 seconds.
Oh my God, look at the countdown. It's so cute.
She looks good.
Pop off.
Okay. Is that a cardigan?
I need a cardigan.
Is that an invisible string?
I'm like the water when your ship rolled in that night. You cut through like a knife.
I think I
went
with this.
Lost in a cold like a
who was that? That was a younger version of that.
It's a love story.
We love an analysis.
She's drunk.
Fuck.
That's a bad fucking bitch.
I have bad business. I don't know what's going on, but she's like, I would watch this movie.
Yeah. Oh my God, it's a seance.
What's that song?
Willow.
Oh shit! He ripped off a mask.
That looked hot.
That was really beautiful.
I'm inspired. Go off, Willow.
Willow, the video.
I love. Yay! Cheers! Evermore, baby! Song one, done. And it was that song! I'm sorry, whoever heard that.
It just stopped whatever they were doing.
Evermore by Dan Stevens is playing on someone else's TV right now. I wish you guys could see it's on the TV.
It's so pretty.
None of these songs are like. But I'm still like. This was the moment where
we're
like.
Yeah, literally. When you hear those. The bridge.
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
And that can go anywhere I want.
One for the watch.
And it's at my wedding.
That was champagne problems.
That was. Yeah,
those radios. They're like Sasha.
That was.
That's exactly that what. Like I leaned into the. Dance. That was.
Next, we got some smooth jazz.
That was so good. Okay. So we've decided to kind of rank them as we go and see what happens. Once again, this is on first listen, so things will definitely change when we actually like learn words and pick up on new things the more we listen. So right now, Champagne Problems is above Willow, but they're both really good so far.
Fuck you, Willow.
Just kidding. Willow, I don't know her. Next up is Gold Rush, so.
Next up.
She'll be.
Next up is Gold Rush
by Taylor Swift.
Ed Sheeran will be calling her shortly.
Hello. On account of her stealing her song title. No, they're friends, right?
The next song is Tolerate It by Taylor Swift.
Happening. So I looked up who wrote the songs because I wanted to know which ones William Bowery wrote, and he wrote co-wrote Champagne Problems and Evermore. so you fucking know it's going down.
The next song is Nobody No Crime.
When you wanted to rhyme. Nobody No Crime featuring
Hyam.
I think that's right.
I think that sounds better.
What's happening?
The police?
A cab.
Okay. Oh, I vibe with this shit. I don't even know what's happening yet.
It's like Kendrick. I'm ready.
Seriously.
I think I'm gonna call her now. She says, I think he did.
had it coming, but
Chicago. Literally.
At the Olive Garden.
Not Olive Garden. Not at the Olive Garden.
Anywhere but Olive Garden.
I think he did it too.
Something about this.
I think she's telling
she's
the truth.
Right. I believe her.
Good thing my daddy made me get a boating license when I was 15.
Why the fuck did you do that? Am I at the Olive Garden?
The Olive Garden's out here.
She was with me.
Fuck, is this? A simple favor?
Oh, shit.
I don't know that.
Oh, shit. That one. One, obviously. They went to the Olive Garden. And she has a body license!
Somebody come get her!
Up next is happiness.
Bye. What the fuck is
Taylor Swift?
5 minutes.
Someone say happiness.
All the years I've given are just things we're dividing up. Leave it all behind. So there's
you're surviving with it.
Tell me when did you know I didn't mean that. Sorry, I can't see facts through all of my fury. You haven't met to know me yet.
You hear new me, bitch.
Happiness.
Didn't make me feel that happy. Yes, that music.
No, but I love sad songs. So that one. Kinda got.
No, I definitely like think
but
that
more, like
sad
said,
songs are good, but like
more toward the bridge.
Yeah, I think as a whole it didn't like none of these songs are bad, but when you have to stack them against each other, we have to get into it. Yeah, I think more songs got me like a little more like, oh shit, than that one did.
Yeah, I think this like happiness is a song that I'll probably keep listening to and it will become probably one like it'll probably become better, but like I think at first listen I didn't get
yeah.
much from it, but
yeah, because you have to really listen to those songs,
but
like,
I do think all yeah. All right, next up is Dorothea. It was really catchy.
It was definitely catchy.
It made me want to go Dorothea. I really want to be
ya. No. We love a rhyming queen. I feel like this is a song I'm going to have to listen again to try to figure out like the point of view, because you know it's like some of them are like from Taylor's point of view, but some of them are from character point of view.
Yeah,
so, like,
some of them aren't all of them.
So
yeah.
Again, don't hate us if we don't get
Taylor.
The full meaning on the first
we don't
listen.
Know what she's talking about. You're just gonna be fucking honest. Who is Dorothea?
We're just basically.
And why do you want to be?
It's
us?
Basically like what? It's basically just a what do we vibe with right off the bat? Like, what song do we claim right off the bat? And right now, Champagne Problems is just a vibe.
Champagne Problems is a full vibe.
And then next
I relate to Champagne Problems because I have a lot of problems.
The next song is Coney Island featuring The National.
This one doesn't fucking slap, I'll have to sue Taylor Swift.
Cause we were like the mall before the internet. It was the one place to be. Mischief, get drops of dreams. We waiting at a wrong spot in the tree line by the gold cup. They'll leave you hanging every single day.
We're standing in the hallway with a big cake. Happy birthday, did I paint you blue?
Fuck yeah.
Go off.
Fuck yeah.
Fuck yeah. I don't know, there's just something about duets I like, because it feels like two sides of a story. Yeah. Like, I love The Last Time, I love Exile, like, that shit hits.
Next is Ivy by Taylor Swift. Who's Ivy?
I know, that's why people are like, is it about the plants or about a person? It's a plant confirmed.
It's a plant.
Shit. Is that Loki?
Yeah, I don't think Prince. It's Loki himself into the song.
Very nice.
I like that one.
That one was very pretty. I feel like I'll like it more the more I listen to it.
It's so, so pretty and catchy.
Next is Cowboy Like Me by, you guessed it, Taylor Swift on Taylor Swift Radio. Yeah.
Cowboy Like Me, you can't go wrong.
I like the vibe. I don't know how to explain it. That like, is it? That's kind of, that's how I would describe it.
I that one part instead of skyrocketed to the top. This makes me want to marry a cowboy. That was kind of like, that I vibed with it.
Yeah.
Like, I kind of want to be a cowboy in that moment.
No, I don't know how to describe the vibes other than that.
What happened?
Yummy. Nom nom for us, David. Never say nom
nom. Never say nom nom
again. You know what Alexis Rose says? Everybody's got a horse.
Everybody's got a horse.
Nay.
Next up, we have Long Story Short by, you may know her, Taylor Swift.
Maybe. By Taylor Swift. Taylor Swift. Never be so kind, you
forget to be clever. Okay. Word. Word.
This makes me emotional.
Yeah, these are deep lyrics. I might have flashbacks to something that never happened to me.
I read earlier that that's the name of her grandma.
Aww.
Yeah. And it's track 13, and then the last album, track 13 mentioned her grandfather.
Ah.
Epiphany, I think. Makes me emo.
Next up, we have Closure by, you guessed it, Taylor Swift.
What is happening?
I feel like my American Horror Story. Yes, I got your letter. Yes, I'm doing better. It could change to know your letter. Yes, I got cheeky little letter. Yes, I'm doing better. I know that it's over. I don't need your closure. Oh shit, get out!
Closure. I feel like that was like a simple bop.
Yeah,
I feel like I vibe with it.
It was a vibe.
Cheeky bop.
Cheeky little bop. It was pretty simple. And
she said, fuck you and your closure.
Lastly, we're bringing to you the grand finale, Evermore, featuring Bon Iver.
We manifested this shit.
We did manifest the fucking shit.
Now I know she'll never leave me, even as she fades from you.
If it doesn't sound like that, I don't want it.
It's literally that song.
I'll be shook.
And I was catching my breath, staring out an open window, catching my death.
Catching your death?
And
what?
I couldn't feel it so peculiar that this pain would be for evermore.
It's gonna chill me. When Evermore hits you because you love Beauty and the Beast.
When it's the title, it's like the Leonardo DiCaprio thing.
Shook.
They can't go wrong with a Bon Iver feature.
Well, 2 hours later, some wine, a FaceTime in the middle that we had to take, and deliberation. Does that make sense? Is deliberation a word? It's been 2 hours of debt. We came to a conclusion on our original first listen ranking, again subject to change. I think we're gonna revisit next month and see what multiple listens does to our ranking. So starting from the bottom, once again, all of these are gonna get more love soon and get the attention they deserve, so no one be offended.
No one hate it.
Number 15, Tis the Damn Season. I feel like, I don't know, that one didn't spark the joy I was looking for.
It didn't spark anger. No, none of these were like, ooh, what the fuck is that?
Wasn't like, all these were great. Like, I feel like these would be, if we compared a lot of Taylor Swift songs, like, yeah, these all very hold up in just general Taylor Swift songs. 14, Marjorie. I feel like that one was just very, like, solemn.
Yeah.
And slower, and I think a very well-written song, but just when you're like, ooh, I want to put on a song, you don't want to be like,
you're like, Marjorie. Yeah.
Okay.
But it was good.
Number 13, Taylor Swift's lucky number, Happiness. Another song I remember liking a lot, but just not having the like, oh shit, what's happening?
Sad for Happiness.
Yeah, I was like, I wish I was happy with you and I'm happy without you and you can have both. And I was like, you're right. I think this one is an upset to me as, like, starting from the beginning, R12 is Willow, and we start out so strong, be like, this is a great song.
I feel like that's wrong. But it was the first one, so it just got low.
Yeah, I feel like the fact that it was the first one you heard is working against it. And when we re-listen to it, we'd be like, oh, this song fucking slaps, so get ready for a Willow comeback.
And we're not
Willow
roasting her.
Yeah, Willow warriors out there. You're gonna have some fucking time. We're gonna come back for her. She's gonna get the time she deserves.
She's gonna
come back up in the ranking.
I don't know what the fuck she's doing below Closure.
Yeah, we put Closure at 11, and I genuinely
we made a few mistakes, but
okay, Closure we just listened to. I feel like, let's say Closure and Willow are like tied for 11.
Yeah, they could be tied.
They could be cheeky sisters. 10, Dorothea. Everyone wants to be her.
Dorothea kind of fucking slapped when I like think about it.
Yeah, I feel like she could be higher too later.
It was
upon more listens.
Yeah, it was just catchy.
It was a good time. 9, Ivy.
Yeah, Ivy.
We found out it was about a plant.
Yeah, and it was good.
It was good.
I thought it was going to be about a person. Me too. It was about a plant, and it slept.
What if it was about Teddy's best friend, Uncle Luck Charlie?
Oh.
I feel like if it was, it'd be number one. That's my only critique. 8, Cowboy Like Me.
like, you just want to go to the fucking rodeo and find yourself a fucking cowboy.
7, Gold Rush, a song that I remember us loving at the beginning.
And yeah, I remember vibing to it, but then I totally, like, blank slate, like, of what it sounds like and what...
Yeah.
It sounds
like. Once again.
Anything about it. Don't know.
It was 3 on the track list, so, like, anything up higher, like, Willow was number 1, just was working against it in terms of, like, having memory of it. We did this over the course of 2 hours.
I mean, short-term memory. We kids a lot.
So, I definitely think Gold Rush will get higher. For sure. 6, Coney Island. Just a fucking good time.
Just a fucking good time. The National was there. Yeah.
They were there. You were there. I was there. Basically, Coney Island was just a good freaking time.
Coney Island was a good time. We were all there at Coney Island cotton candy.
5, Evermore. I feel like we're Miss Bojo.
5, Evermore.
Mm-hmm. Another song that could go up the more we listen to it because, like, it was very good.
Mm-hmm.
I just think...
That's the title.
Yeah, when it's the self-title.
My man.
Mm-hmm. Bonnie.
Rosalind bitch.
Tolerate It. That one you were very
Tolerate It. I was very passionate about that. What I remember, it slapped. It made me want to make a fan of it.
Yeah, no, I feel like I don't remember it as much, but I feel like I would like it more if I listened to it. Number 3, Long Story Short. That's that was just slapped. I don't even
like
it was I have no memory of any of these songs if I'm being honest.
Long at this point. Yeah, but I just remember Long Story Short, like the whole time I was like, this is catchy, this is good.
2, Nobody No Cryum with Chaim. That song was just fucking fantastic.
It was so good.
So good. I love feminism. Taking down the man.
Yeah, I'm gonna take down the man.
Yeah, that's, Alright, and then number 1, the one we couldn't let go of, even though we forgot.
I have no fucking clue what it sounded like.
We ranked them. We're competing to our ranking with Champagne,
Champagne problems
at 1.
Just the name should get.
Yeah, it's a pretty good name. And that was number 2 in the checklist, and we kept it, because we were like, it's so good, and for some reason none of them made us feel the way we did, even though we don't remember how we felt. Okay.
I feel good about our
list. I feel very good about this first listen list. I'm sure everyone has their own opinions, but that's the point. That's what's the fun of music.
This is fun.
Guys.
Listen, we've only had 2 hours and we listened to the freaking song 1 time. Cut us some fucking slack.
That about wraps us up. There's only one thing left to say. Hey, Queen. Girl, you have done it again. I'd say I'm surprised, but I know who you are. Evermore, beautiful album, just like Folklore. I can't wait to listen to them as I fall asleep tonight, which we need to go to sleep. In conclusion, if you like this, if you like Taylor Swift, you gotta subscribe because we're gonna re-rank them all next month and then get really into the freaking nitty gritty.
Remember to like, subscribe, comment below what your favorite song from Evermore was.
Yep. I'm excited to hear it. And give us your full ranking, too. Like, just
give us your fucking top 20.
And then we'll have a battle royale. See you guys next month. Bye.
Cheers.
Happy 31st birthday, Taylor Swift! Woo! Cheers! Evermore. Into many, many evermore.